So we're going to continue on some wiring diagrams, but this time we're using the two plate method. The two plate method is where you take the supply to the switch first and not to the ceiling rose, batten lamp holder, etc., like we did when we looked at the three plate method. Sometimes this is called taking the feed or supply to the switch, but an AM2 and AM2S, I've heard students come out and say, I was asked to wire the lighting circuit using the two plate method. So we're gonna look at the wiring diagram for this. I've also done a nice video on the channel as well, where I've cabled this in as a one-way circuit, then a two-way, and then a two-way and intermediate. And we're gonna use these drawings, this one being the one-way one, to support those videos that are on the channel. So as always, for our lighting circuits at college, we're gonna be using 1mm² PVC, PVC twin and CPC cable, brown, blue, and a bare conductor, which we'll identify on the drawing with green and yellow sleeving with a green and yellow pen. So it's going to require us to take the supply, in this case, from the consumer unit directly to the switch, and then from the switch up to the lighting point itself. This is often used in industry where there's loads of downlighters, say in a kitchen area, etc. The electrician will bring the supply directly to the switch, and then from the switch to the lighting point itself, it cuts down the number of cables at the lighting point. This is a wiring diagram, so remember that these are meant to help you make the connections. However, within the consumer unit, we'll be bringing the brown conductor into the top of the breaker, the blue conductor into the neutral bar, and the green and yellow one identified for our CPC into the earth bar. And that's not quite what we've got here. However, this is a one-way switch, and with our one-way switch, we can clearly see we've got common and L1, exactly the same as what we've got here on our actual drawing itself. So common and L1 for our light switch. And then our light fitting up here is slightly different as well. I've just left three connecting points and a lamp. That's likely to be an LED lamp, and it will be using in industry something like this, say a joint that requires the cables to go into it, and then from here to the downlight, or one that looks like this, a little bit bigger. Okay, again, a cable jointing area. Could be something like this. One side here, this side here connecting to the mains cable, this side here connecting to the flex to the LED downlight. Sometimes themselves, LED downlights have the actual connections themselves built into the actual fitting, so our solid cables would be coming in here. Or it could be that we've got that flex and the LED lights and we're required to use one of the joints that we've looked at or something similar to it. So here is just a jointed area that then goes to the light itself. It's likely there'll be more than one lighting point. This is quite difficult to lay out as we actually draw it because of the way I've got my different accessories. So I'm going to bring a cable up and then down into here, and a cable from here up into my lighting point itself. So as we said, twin and CPC cable, or twin and earth. So that's what we're going to be using. So I've got to be careful how I put my conductors round to stop it looking too crowded in the switch itself. So let's start off with bringing in the CPC. So we're going to start off with a CPC, then we'll do our neutral, and then we'll do our line. So it's important that I bring it round so I can show my connections are clearly in here. So let's start off with the CPC. So I'm going to bring it up just out of the way, and then I'm going to bring it down, and I want to make sure that I don't clash with any of my other conductors. So for this one, I'm actually going to bring it into the light and just swing it round into my earth terminal. We'll try and keep it as clear as I possibly can. The chances are my students will also strike the side of this yellow, so it looks a little bit more like the CPC sleeving you expect to see. But it's going to get a little bit crowded in here. Remember, there is another video that supports this. The next one, our neutral connection, would come out the neutral bar, is going to be left in the switch, and we'll make a connection to that. So let's bring the neutral round. So I'm going to bring my neutral round, and I'm just going to leave it at the moment floating in the actual accessory or in the back of the box. Next, my line conductor. I'm going to bring that out, my consumer unit, out the top of the probably 6-amp breaker with RCD protection. And then we're going to bring that down. I'm going to kick that into the common. So what I've done there is I've taken my cable straight on my consumer unit, and I've got my neutral CPC and line conductor coming out, and I've brought that cable directly into my switch. I've left the neutral at the moment floating. The CPC is connected into the earth terminal. We use plastic boxes at college. It could be into a metal box or a metal front. You need to make the CPC connection in the appropriate place. And my line conductor, in this case from the top of my fuse, comes directly into the common of my switch. So comes directly into the common of my one gang one-way switch. Okay, so it's in there. So that's the first cable brought in, and then we're going to bring a cable out that comes out and feeds our lighting point or lighting points, depending on how it's going to work. So again, this is tricky for me because obviously I want to keep cables away and make it as clear as I possibly can in here. But the neutral itself is going to need joining. So if I put just something on there to suggest that's a connection of some sort. So that's a connector. It could be a simple 5-amp connector block in the back of the box. It could be one made by somebody like Wago. So it could be a Wago connector or something like this from Insure. But they're going to need to make a connection in there. Some switches themselves actually have an extra terminal spare for a neutral connection. Okay, that might become more and more common as the years pass, but we're at college going to probably have to be using a connector and leave it floating in the back of the box itself. So all I'm going to do now is bring out a cable which will have a switching line, CPC and neutral up to my light fitting itself. So let's start off by looking at the neutral. I'm going to have to bring it round and try and clear my switch. So I've got, it's how does Gary do it so it makes it look nice and neat? That's the problem. So let's bring out the neutral. Okay, and I'll just try and drift it around the bottom here, and then I can look to bring that one out. So my neutral comes out. We're gonna bring out our CPC. So that one comes out. And we're gonna bring out our switching line conductor, which will come out of L1. So we're gonna bring that round as well. So you notice it's a little crowded in there. So once I've got it in this position here, you can clearly see that's one cable. So that is one cable, twin and CPC coming in with a permanent line, neutral and CPC. And then we've got a twin and CPC cable coming out. They're all 1 mil up my college with a switching line, neutral and CPC. So it's just a case now of making sure we join these up in a logical manner. So we take our green one, we'll take our brown one, so our switching line conductor into here, and then finally we'll take our neutral round as well. It wouldn't matter which holes we used in this connection here if they were unlabeled. If they were labeled, we'd have to put them in the appropriate terminals, and then that connection would connect directly to the actual LED light. So we'd bring either just the switching line and neutral through to my LED light, or if the LED light wasn't double insulated, we'd bring the CPC as well. So remember, we're looking for a double insulated symbol on the actual light fitting like so to suggest it doesn't need a CPC. So if we look at this one here, you can see we have the double insulated symbol just there, and therefore the only connections required for this one are switching line and neutral in order to make those connections. So this is our LED light fit, and these are our two cables. We've taken our supply, our permanent line, neutral and CPC from, in this case, our consumer unit directly into the switch. The permanent line went into common. We made a connection for our neutrals that wasn't currently in the switch, so we made that using one of our connectors. And we connect our CPC into our earth terminal. That was our first 1mm² cable coming in. Then we took another 1mm² cable out, and we took out our switching line, our neutral and our CPC, again, which my students are likely to want to put a yellow stripe down. It is only one cable, remember, but it just looks a little bit more like it. In order that we bring up here, switching line, neutral and CPC, and we feed this light. If we wanted more than one spotlight, say in the room, to come on, all we would do would be taking a green and yellow, blue and a neutral. In other words, another one of these cables from the same connecting points to the next spotlight, the next spotlight and the next spotlight, and you find then you've only got a maximum of two twin and CPC cables at any one spotlight in the system if you're using the two plate method. The two plate method means the supply comes into the switch and then we make our connections in here and we bring one cable out in order to feed our LED down lights, etc. Very common practice in industry using the two plate method. And I do have other videos on the channel where I show how to make all the connections physically on a board and how to test the one way, then I extend it to two way and two way and intermediate. This is the first video in this series of which we're using the two plate method for wiring diagrams. There will be a link in the description for all the drawings I've used in my series on lighting circuits if you wanted to download this and make your own version up, or perhaps even fill it in similar to me. Remember students, you will be using a ruler. Gary hasn't used a ruler, and I've also done it upside down, so you'll be making a slightly neater job than this, and you might want to label that as a connector as well in the actual switch itself. So as always, I hope this video has been some help.